The University of Tennessee Knoxville is home to the nation's first fully automated electric bike sharing station. Make that two stations. Thanks to research questions posed by Civil and Environmental Engineering Assistant Professor Chris Cherry.
We have electric assist bikes, so that have an electric motor in the hub that allows users to go up hills with more ease. We also have regular bicycles that are included in the system. So if somebody has a preference for regular bicycles, they can use those regular bicycles.
One station, located in Presidential Court, uses power off the grid. The other, on the agriculture campus, uses solar power. Registered members of Cherry's pilot program easily check out bikes with a swipe of their university ID.
When the user wants to check out a bike, first they got to check out a battery. Here we have a battery vending system that allows us to distribute the right battery to the user, the battery that assures a minimum state of charge, meaning they can go a certain distance on a single charge. We give them the battery. This is a lithium-ion battery. They close the door. Then we send them to a bike, an electric bike that's ready to go. They slide the battery in the back, lock it up, and then check the bike out.
Cherry and his team are collecting data on a number of questions related to safety, environmental impact, and travel behavior to see if electric bikes could become more popular here in the U.S.
Now, one of the main motivations for including electric bikes in a bike sharing system is I was hoping to expose more people to a relatively very efficient mode of transportation. And a lot of people won't bicycle around campus or around East Tennessee because of the terrain and the weather and other things. Electric bikes can help overcome that.
According to Cherry, electric bikes also overcome air quality and environmental health issues by displacing other more polluting modes of transportation.